all the race walkers out there. And really good to see that they've sent a team of three to this event as well.
On your mark.
Well, circumstances have forced this joint start, but I do think it's actually possibly unique. It's certainly in recent history, I can't remember a major international championship where the women have started alongside the men at 20 kilometres. Of course, women have the men and the women starting alongside each other over 50 kilometres back on Tuesday. At the World Championships, it was two different starts.
Well, we're seeing it in the marathon, of course, when we have races that are being held jointly between the two. We've got male pacers, and yes, I think you might be right, and I think we saw it in the women's 50k race on Tuesday when Ines Henriquez was starting to roll up and collect some of the male racers there as well, and she did really well for the conditions and came very close to her former world record from last year.
Well, this does raise a statistical question. In some of the running world records, there are separated women's only records and mixed records. I wonder if you're going to see those on the books for race walking now.
I was wondering that earlier as well, and I do not have the answer. I don't know how often we actually see men and women in the same race in
the The idea now is that possibly we will see many more joint races. I don't know, I mean, this is a situation that has actually been forced upon us because of circumstances, and quite appropriately so. Safety measures have to be taken. And I actually rather like the idea of the men and the women starting together. It makes for bigger fields, it makes for a more attractive race.
I think so too, and actually I just bumped into Paula in the media centre, and she is here just sitting alongside from us, also talking about this race for the BBC, and she was saying, oh, I'm curious how many of the women have actually finished ahead of them.
Well, we need to see the race with the women's 50-kilometre walk on Tuesday, and so finished ahead of a number of the men, and she was finished just inside 4 hours 10 minutes. 5 minutes outside her former world best. That's a 6-meter open, but that world best was set in the 2017 World Championships. And so she came up ahead of
great setup they have there with the Kaiser Wilhelm Memorial Church right alongside it. Then we can just see, for those of you who are not that familiar with the race walking on the road events, they have these little red, orangey circles on their shoes that are the timers. On the track, we often see athletes having timers stuck to their bibs, but these guys on the road, they have the timers on their shoes.
Section for not having contact continuously. So a little bit of trial by television there.
And I like the fact here that the young Briton Colin Wilkins is going out there and leading the field. He's just 21 years of age, won the world junior title in Big Bosch in 2016 and became Britain's first global champion in a race walking event since Kim Matthews at the 1964 Olympics. And that's a bold race walker. Is it maybe the guys being a bit worried they've got women behind them and wanting to crank up the pace a little? No, it's a double barrel. It's verbal into a dissing. Dim Siendo.
Get it right by the end.
Not enough time to practice there. An hour and a half.
See, several of the main protagonists to the fore. On the left hand side of the screen. Portugal, Georgia. Also up there in a Kashima.
In terms of conditions, I think it's near perfect out there. They might want it a couple of degrees colder because I think they prefer the colder conditions much more close to the hot ones as the road does heat up as well. But overall, I'd say this should be pretty good for the race walkers out there on the course.
Side, Hansen, the women.
stadium San Maria, which we saw this morning, is Gerard Dennis, a Frenchman, who of course set that 50 kilometers world record in Zurich. Very confident in his abilities, he doesn't want to go out there too early. Remember, the other German you see on the right-hand side finished sixth at the Under 23 European Championships in 2015, 8th in 2013, 25 years old now. Last year at the World Championships and was quite happy with his performance there because he went sub 120 for the first time in his career. And I'd say the conditions in London were tougher than they're out there because it was quite a bit warmer on that day, which is rare in London in terms of temperatures.
Let each other know how they are feeling.
rider, Vivaldi is here from Lithuania. It's the German Nemo, just got two off the bat. He's 21 years of age, so the lesser experienced walkers in this field of 30 women.
Well, they are both the men's athletes. but definitely being somewhere in the country box. I can't quite see him, but the man you see there in the green vest from Ireland, Alex Wright, is actually coached by Robin Heffernan. So they're looking very good. Heffernan, of course, has won numerous medals on the international scene. And the 27-year-old Irish athlete looking pretty good so far. I would love to see to get an idea of who's got how many cards. At the moment, we haven't got an update on that, but as soon as we do get any more information on that, as the athletes pass the big stations, we will let you know.
Wieder auf eine Medaille stellen. Aneska Drahatova aus der Tschechischen Republik, die führende aktuell.
You just saw that bike riding there with the leading men. They've also got loads of guys on inline skates, but of course as well. I think that's about still 25 athletes there packed together. But Paula now, Hagen Paula, former World Youth and European Junior Champion, moved to the front and took over from the Esplenbach, the other German. He's now dropped back a bit. You can see him there with the white cap behind the other white cap worn by the Spaniard. So three Germans there very closely. Paula, 26 years of age. Quite a bit of experience international as well. And he has won plenty of national titles and age group championships. And of course, that world youth gold in 2009 over 10,000 meters.
Thank you.
these athletes can race more than 20 kilometres in. See, it's fairly easy to say, we'll say that 1 hour and 20 minutes, there or thereabouts, depending on conditions.
That would be quite a fast time. It's
in that as well. And now we've got the three Germans united again at the front as we take the heavy Irish athletes right.
I don't expect that to be 6 kilometres an hour, but 26:34 at 6 kilometres. Just listen to myself and Michelle Sam. We'll make sure we get the right information. We're trying to decide where the information we're getting, but we're doing a good job of keeping up with the kilometres. Right over now. Now back to the main group. Contains two Lithuanians, not just Gabalte Vinicien, but also Diko Kevichelai. Something that can be said about the race walking as well. There's so much technique that goes into it, so much you have to pay attention to, and you really have to make sure you are holding your form and not lifting your leg, because of course one of your feet always has to stay on the ground, visible to the human eye, I should say. Judging by the shade the athletes are getting from the trees that are lining the road along the course, it does look pretty sunny out there. Quite as much on 20 kilometres as it was on 50 kilometres. We're now starting to see the men lap So, women operating at a predicted winning time at around the 1:28 and a half. Now moving over to get some refreshment, get some liquid around her. Still striding out, putting distance between herself and the chasing group is Pepe Chite. To try and close that gap before it gets too large. Chased by Italians and the rest of the women. Still a very large group at the fore of the men's race. During the first half of the race and then came through steadily and actually increased his pace and got to the front at 33 kilometres in the half.
Whereas, of course, in the women's race, Ines Henriquez never in doubt, just raced her own race completely and collected some men on her way to gold as well.
Yes, I wonder if Julia Tekac in that race, just reflecting on it, because Tekac, of course, has also raced very well over 20 kilometres this year. But has decided just to focus on the 50 kilometres at these championships. I wonder whether Tekac, who eventually finished third and actually looked relatively fresh when she came through, misjudged her tactics, but I think that's probably lack of experience. She's only got now a couple of 50 kilometre races under her belt, and I think Tekac could be somebody to keep an eye on next year.
Eine Schleife oben noch und dann haben wir auch schon Streckenhälfte bei den Männern.
Noch einmal hier der Griff zum nassen Schwamm zur Erfrischung.
32-year-old. Just got a yellow card there as well. So in the 20k, where they are going a bit faster. He's really built up a significant gap there on Stano and the rest of the field there. Stano, the second Italian of three. And Rubino moving away from the field a bit there. As they are approaching halfway point.
Yeah,
somebody else, maybe the other Italian starter, was yellow card there. I'm not quite sure whether that was exactly with them being so closely together. It's difficult to tell, and they go through 10 kilometers in 46. There it says Bloomberg is leading. But to me, that's Bloomberg there, as you can see, on the left-hand side. I think it was Link actually got that yellow card there. Beano leading, as we can see, Gold Chapel there.
Well, it's not so much a problem in this particular event as being on the track, is that there's a whole slew of different nationalities with very similar kits. The Italians look very similar to the Finnish, the Norwegians look very similar to the British. And in this sort of distance event, you see a lot of athletes with the white vests, in some cases an alternate strip. In theory, it's to reflect the sunlight a little bit better and be actually a little bit cooler. Not an issue today.
And of course, the Swedes and the Ukrainians are also very similar as well. So these are, if we do get confused, please bear with us. We're trying to correct ourselves as best as possible.
I'm just seeing that Belarus walker through there. Yes, and of course, we don't have many green vests in there, but distinguishing Belarus and Ireland is sometimes
and Hungary.
Yes. Hungarians often appear in the red vest, but this time they're running green apparel.
In this corner, we also saw in the 50-kilometer race walk, and I think it's quite a tight one, especially with all of them still very closely together. It's just kind of where they are crossing from one side of the road to the other, and it's tight. Here we can see the Lithuanian athletes in the women's field moving up on the quarter east. He is being lapped by the
Two barrels, well, not one of the stronger of the Portuguese competitors in this field, but Fiku Chemichite doing very well. Lapping at around 4.22, she's been very consistent at 4.22 laps. The gap has grown very slightly between herself and a three or four woman chasing. Chasing group. Chasing group with Palmasino, Italy, Dorovska, Ukraine, China, or Portugal, Ratova of Czech Republic. That's the other Lithuanian starting to struggle just a little bit. Balte Limicia. Cappuccino. Cappuccino looking a little bit tired. They're starting to get detached, although the Lithuanian is now starting to get a second wind and try and get back up there with the group that's actually chasing her compatriot. Not far from the halfway point, the women now. That's one of the Romanians being lapped. Asim. She's got a pretty decent record competitively. She's the current Romanian champion. So, it's an indication of how well the Lithuanian leader is operating.
I would say the Valentin Dempsey-Enyo is looking pretty strong there out in front. Made up quite the gap there, of course, not to be confused with that Romanian athlete who's being lapped in there. Led by Drautova, who of course are trying to close that gap a little because you don't want it to become too big to then trying to make up a lot of space, because as we've seen with Callum Wilkinson, of course, when you inject a bit of pace, mistakes in technique can also happen, and that's when cards get awarded. Georgi there just got a yellow card, we can see.
The Lithuanian on the moment well on the way to breaking the personal best of 1:29.02. Set a little bit earlier this year, when she came 10th in Taikang. Still a chasing group of five. This will go up in laps for Romania.
Right for Ireland there. Irish Junior Champion, 5,000 metres. He was a DNF in Taichung. I didn't get up to watch the race in China, so I'm not sure whether it was based on form or based on being awarded too many yellow cards. He's looking pretty good there, the Robert Heffernan coached athlete. Ukrainians now moving forward in the field, and it's similar to what we've seen in the men's 50 kilometer race, where of course the title was won by the Ukraine. All four Spaniards still in that leading group as well. It has thinned out a little. Shopping centre, similar to what you find in London, the Selfridges and so on. So the guys can go shopping straight after the race if they want.
Well, we've got 7 hours between the end of this race and the evening session.
Well, you can go there, that's a good coffee shop on the corner as well, Phil. I'll show you that.
Kick you to a donut.
Maybe a pretzel, it's not sure.
Prefer a donut. Anyway.
There we can see Ride leading the field from one of the Spaniards. Link is still very much up there at the front. Amescura and Gabriel Carrera, the two Spaniards, and Martín right there at the front. Most accomplished of the Spaniards actually at the back of this group. Miguel Angel Lopez. Seeing Linka's necklace there flip around, I'm always amazed at the jewelry that male athletes are wearing, especially in the sprints. We often see some heavy necklaces and so forth. Really irritated by that.
Compared to what we've seen in some of the sprints.
They're a bit of bumping and barging as the large field. There we can see, as if they
read this. Your mind.
They did. But we could just see Linka there having to move to the other side of the track because he was overtaking one of the female athletes, and that's just basically because the male leading pack is still so large and so close together. So just a bit of traffic coming up there, and you can see some of the athletes missing the water bottles because of the size of the field.
Well, now Dratova has closed down on a Lithuanian rival. They've gone through the halfway point. We didn't have a split for that, and we're missing that time, but I'll try and update you as we go along. We're now well into the 11th kilometre. Grant over now. Norwich has adopted very different tactics than from Zurich 4 years ago, when she sped away over the first 10 kilometres and then gradually wilted, but she did hang on for the bronze medal. Right over now, 23 years of age. Personal best of 126.53, the Czech at the front.
And in the Zwischenzeit gab es wieder einen
Yes, it's a bit of a truism. We still got 9 kilometers to go, but this race is far from over.
45 Minuten knapp, die die Dame schon unterwegs ist. Die Dame im Rotkopf am linken Fuß zu sehen.
Seven or eight meters between herself as Parmigiano starts to push a little bit to try and get back on the shoulder of Gratova. Sometimes it's a little bit deceptive, but it does look as though the Sheena is starting to strain a little bit. Now Crane in fourth place at the moment.
And it looked like the Spaniard Pérez just got a yellow warning card there as well in third currently. So this is something that also plays on the athletes' minds. They know they've got two strikes, the third one is out, and there's nothing more disappointing, I think, than already getting well beyond that halfway line and then receiving that third card. So really now a matter of paying attention to form.
Well, 12 kilometers passed in 52.42. I can tell you we've had the information come through now. They did actually pass the halfway point in 43.59. Very fractionally inside 1:28 pace. This is a very good time from the women. Swaying braids of Anesha Gratova.
Best to look out for. On the inside, now making a little move there on the shoulder of Martin. Finished 16th in high jump at the World Race Walking Team Championships. Paula's still leading though. I'm glad he's wearing that yellow hat. It makes him very easy to spot. I wish if there were more coloured hats or anything to tell them apart for that matter. As I said, some of the vests look very similar. There, Garcia doing us a favour with wearing his hat the wrong way round.
Looks like Stano just got a warning there as well. So yellow cards flying amongst the leading men at the moment.
Which could make things interesting as we enter the latter stages of this race. We're into the 14th kilometre now of this race.
It's coming up to complete 13 kilometres.
There's the 14 kilometre split for the men, 57:19, and as you can see by the times, they're still very close together. The first four all getting the same time. Slightly confused by this rain guard featuring, they're always at the top of the list because he is not the leader. It's definitely hard for all of the Germans, so just bear with us and we're trying to keep you as updated as possible.
Well, now we switch from the leader in the men's race to the leader in the women's race, and it's Aneska Dratova. Well, she threw in a couple of very good kilometres of 4:18 and 4:17 in the 11th and 12th kilometre. She's on course for a finishing time around 1:28, so she's certainly thrown down the ball to the rest of the women.
And the Lithuanian there had that huge gap early on, now fading back a little.
Well, she was operating more than half a minute inside of her personal best pace. But it is at the moment in the medal position. Dratova, Carmesino, and Martin Perez. Perez took the Spanish title. That was her first Spanish title. She had a silver medal at the European Under 23 Championships. That's very good. That's the slightly veiled Spaniard in third place at the moment. The battle at the moment at the front seems to be between Dratova and Calmazano.
And now it's getting quite busy on this route because we can see the three leaders over there. And just behind them, we can see the bicycle. We could see there's a very large board that says how many cars have been awarded, who has been disqualified so far. Unfortunately, we can't see that board because we are in the Olympic Stadium, about 6 kilometres from the course. And unfortunately, they're not showing on our results. But as soon as we see anything, we've already seen the Britain come. Leave the competition in the earlier stages because of too many yellow cards. And there we can see Tom Bosworth now has moved up quite a bit from the back, the Briton, sixth at the Rio Olympics.
I was going to say, it's not been a good day though for Britain as far as yellow red cards are concerned, because Heather Lewis from Britain has also been disqualified in the women's race, as has Yana Smirnova of Russia, racing as an authorised neutral athlete. So we've lost two women from that starting lineup of 30. Still at the front. It's Ratova and Parmigiano battling for the title.
Yeah, Tom Boswell, of course, he suffered exactly that same fate last year at the World Championships on home soil. He was distraught when he got that third yellow card, but has often shown a bit of lack in terms of technique, in terms of not always keeping feet on the ground. 61.15, he goes through the 50-kilometer mark. The Briton there, and really will be making sure that his form stays, because as soon as you tie, you start making mistakes, and that's when you start lifting the feet.
Well, for viewers and listeners in Turkey and Romania, I'm afraid I've got some bad news for you as well, because Korkmaz of Turkey and Strebu of Romania have also been disqualified along with Kanagur and Sinek Estate. And yes, we only have partial information. I can tell you there's a number of walkers who are carrying two yellow cards.
Amazing up there, the Russian authorized neutral athlete on Bosworth's shoulder, as are the two Spaniards. Hag and Paula, there you can see in the yellow cap, has dropped off quite a bit, as has Christopher Linko, who has been leading quite well in the early stages. And there we could just briefly see the man with the yellow bib, the defending champion, Miguel Angel López, also not part of that leading group. So we've got two Spaniards there, Garcia Carrera and Martin. We've got two Italians, Tom Bosworth there for Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and Niels Breenbach and the Pole. I believe it was Kosovsky trying to close that gap on that leading group of six.
Also been carrying two yellow cards, so that may have had an effect as well. She may just have decided just to race rather conservatively and just finish and hopefully get a reasonable time.
So Bosworth, it's difficult for us Germans to say when there's a TH and an S in it. So Bosworth there now at the back of that group, the Italians, you can see how tight the corners here are, having to hold on to each other as they move swiftly around these corners, and there Bosworth now making up ground on one of the Italians.
Italians are almost giving each other a slingshot like they do often in speed skating.
Never seen that in race racing before. But the authorised neutral athlete is enough. He said that on 18.4 earlier this season. Looking good there. Checking his own time on his watch. Bosworth grimacing, although he often does, although it might be a sign of question. One of the Italians there, Rubino, dropping off that leading group. It's now the leading group of four, so reduced from six to four. Second Italian also losing ground. Martin and Garcia Carrera.
Well, that's what I was wondering. It does look as though it's a little bit slippery and there's a little bit of changing colour on the ground as we look at the Czech Republic. Now she's put some ground between herself and Maria Perez. Oh, look at that! There's been a collision between one of the men and one of the women. So, Parmesan.
And that was Alex Wright, the Irish athlete, I believe.
I hope that was a slip rather, but Parmesano wasn't affected there, so I'm thinking it probably was a slip rather than contact.
But it is, I think, as we see, the corners are really tight, and now that we are seeing the athlete and the athletes, it is more crowded than before. So I'd say definitely start with looking at the ground.
Tripped up over his own feet and just very nearly, although she escaped unscathed, but very nearly brought down Antonella Parmesano. But that was just Alex Wright tripping up over his own feet there.
There they are next to each other again. Let's hope they'll stay away from each other this time around.
Well, I think they'll get separated very shortly. Yes, now Alex Wright finding a bit of space on his own. I think that'll keep Antonella Parmesano happy. Kvyatova pushing hard. Maria Perez now. She's closed down to only about 5 seconds. 5 meters, I should say, or about 2 seconds behind the Czech. Rodia from Romania, 147, Kilyuk from Ukraine, their last athletes. Kvyatova. Kvyatova has actually lapped some of the men. Clear space for Perez to eye the distance between her. And Perez is slowly but surely closing down on Kvyatova. Kvyatova though has raced flawlessly so far. We don't see any yellow cards for her. Perez has got one. Somewhat different in statures, I think that's fair comment.
Yeah, I think we've got one of the tallest and one of the shortest in the field here together.
Presentation of the high check the other day, and we had Opsuna at 1 meter 75 alongside Alessia Trust at 1 meter 90. 6 inches difference in imperial measurement. So Perez now making a beat for glory, putting 2 meters between herself and Mishka Kvyatova. We don't have 15 kilometres before we just at the moment. There's the moment where Perez takes the lead. Now will it be the crucial moment in this race?
Another Spaniard in the lead, or two I should say. Martín there looking very strong as he is leading Garcia Pareja. Very closely that group of three together with Mizanov and Russia. We've only got leaders from Spain in the men's and women's. And it's interesting to see Miguel.
Would be hoping that as well. There's no team race in the race walks. There is a team race tomorrow in the marathons, though.
Oh, and there we've got the Russian now between the two Spaniards. We can just see the way they are moving around.
mechanism of the meats between two slices of bread.
Thank you.
that Garcia Pereira and Isinoff, who are still very committed to get this really close back in there for silver and between the two. I'm pretty sure you could say that Alvaro Martinez has that goal put him to the man unless he faced very badly.
Over the course of the last kilometre, a 20-kilometre race walks, but my hunch is that he's odds on favourite. As we now look back down the course to fellow Spaniard María Pérez. Well, Pérez now starting to build quite a commanded lead over Agnieszka Kvitová. Down the course, it's about 50 metres between the diminutive Spaniard and the very tall Czech. Pérez has gradually improved their championship performance. He's still only 22 years of age. He's the great athlete at the moment. Tonella Parmigiano. Pérez, 10th at Muscular World Championships, 7th at the World Team Championships back in May. Now, he's highly likely to be on the podium. As I said, nothing is guaranteed until they cross the line. 19 kilometres for the men in 118-19. Zano starting to move us quite a bit.
And there is the leader in the men's race. As he really approaches the opposite side of the finish line, he'll just have to go up this way once more and then take that final very tight turn, as we have seen, and encourage that goal. There the crowd cheering him on, and really a great turn out there along the course. Fantastic atmosphere.
Da ist der zweitplatzierte Diego Garcia und der dritte aktuell Vasily Misinov.
Really cheering, and you can see that with the patriot Garcia Pereira is currently in second. Really just a few more 100 metres to go for Álvaro Martín. Has a bronze from the World Team Championships 2 years ago to his name. And there he is now, coming around the bend. The leader, he will be crowned the European champion 2018. So the title goes from Spain to Spain. Miguel Ángel López, the defending champion, hands over to Álvaro Martín. So back-to-back titles for Spain in the men's 20-kilometer race. Celebrating. It looks like Spain gets the silver. Martín there turning around, making sure that the others haven't moved up close on the shoulder. He will be happy to see Garcia Pereira get the silver. He takes his hat off so you can see his face for the photographs as he crosses the line.
Final 3 or 4 kilometres, breaking away from his compatriot Diego Garcia and also the Russian. A fantastic champion under these conditions. Inside 1:21 is certainly an excellent time. He becomes the 5th Spanish champion at the European Athletics Championships.
Very good indeed. And nice back is there. We have the defending champion Lopez. Just thinking very strongly. Thomas Bothworth there. I think it's sick. Hagen poorly coming through. The other German. So a strong finish there for Lopez because he hasn't really featured anywhere near the front.
Well, came off from a long way back. Raced very well over those final 2 kilometres. But to no avail. But it's his compatriot Marta Garcia will be on the podium, as probably will be this woman as well, Maria Pérez as well. She's racing away. She's got about another 5.5 minutes on the road ahead of her. It's about 1.5 kilometres as she passed under that country. Very, very first kilometres to break away from Oscar Baratova and Tamara Parmesano. We've got better championship credentials than her, although she is the silver medalist from last year at the European Under 23 Championships when they were in the Holy City football.
And of course, it's important now not to get too carried away. She's just seen two hatreds of hers.
Finishing first and second, and really want to get out there, joining them in their celebration. So of course, she has already got a young car tour, so now it's about getting to keeping your feet on the ground and making sure that your feet are quite. I'll just see the first finishing time of Álvaro Martín, 1:20.42 for the Spaniard. Finally, our data systems have woken up and sprung into life, and they can tell us that Maria Pérez is on her final kilometre. She's got no less than a 22-second gap now between herself and Agnieszka Dratova. I think that's awesome. To always have said that many times you actually say it's converted, but it's red men cross the line, and suddenly, as we've seen, it's a bit slippery out there, but this is also perfect conditions for very fast times. Excellent times in men's race. Pérez is certainly on course for a big personal best. She's going to smash her best at 1:28.50 that she set each time coming. Third as well at the moment is Palmisano. She's 28 seconds back behind Dratova. Dratova just holding her form now. She got bronze 4 years ago, looking fairly well set for the silver here. Former world junior champion. This was a woman who won the under 20 title in 2010 World Race Walking Championships, as it was then. This is the woman who's looking approaching well on the way to taking the title here in Berlin at the 2018 European Athletics Championships. She's going to be very close to it. She's really improved. I mean, she's been throwing in laps of 4.9, 4.10. Away from her rivals. She's really pouring it on still, despite the Spanish flag in her hand. That's no distraction. This is the final curve. We'll now be able to look down the road and see the finish line. It's a very good one as well. She's moving for about 4 minutes or more behind her. Let's just keep an eye on the clock as well. It will be a championship record. Still striding out, still pouring it on. She's not relaxing. A couple of quick gestures to the crowd. Wondering if she's aware how close to the championship record she is. There's the top. Clock ticks away, Maria Pérez. More than 2 minutes off her personal best. It's going to be Maria Pérez who takes the gold for Spain. Just about to cross the line. Maria Pérez from Spain is the 2018 European champion in the women's 20-kilometre race walk. Just wait for a confirmed time, but I'm pretty sure she has improved the championship record. what keeps on running. Aneska Dragatova comes through for the silver medal. Big smile on the face of the Czech walker. Dragatova just fractionally outside her personal best. 10 seconds outside Czech walker's personal best. This is the winner, this is the gold medalist. 2 gold medals for Spain within the space of about 7 minutes. And Parmigiano, somewhere along the finishing straight, she managed to get hold of an Italian flag. Plenty of Italian race walking fans there. And Antonella Parmigiano takes the bronze. Excellent time as well for the Italian.
And
it reflects
what we were saying this morning. The conditions out there for them were actually pretty good. It wasn't as hot as we've seen earlier in the week. Wind wasn't too strong, a really fantastic performance there. 3 medals go to Spain in the 20-kilometre race walk for men and women.
Well, Spain, of course, fantastic tradition in the men's event. Less so in the women's, but it's certainly a growing one with Maria Perez. Maria Vasco get medals at Olympics and World Championships, but there hasn't been the depth in the women's side that there has on the men's. Well, that's a picture that's going to come here, I'm sure, on the front pages of the 12 daily sports newspapers in Spain. Big hugs for everybody. Just waiting to give you a third time. For Perez, as the clock keeps on ticking, the rest of the women swim home. Well, it is a championship record of 1:26.36. That takes 6 seconds off the previous championship record. Fantastic performance from Maria Perez, the 22-year-old Spaniard.
What I find it fascinating when athletes are watching the race, because there have been clubs around the
world that are, I think it's more the split times, that's what they're doing there. They've got the stopwatches and they're checking the split times as we see Portugal's Ana Pedrafina come through. Fine championship competitor, fourth at the World Championships back in 2015. That's another top 8 finish at these championships, sixth in 2014.
Oh look, it's the Italian and the German flag together there from Parmigiano, with the purple headwear that she had in her hair earlier on. Very nice.
Over, they know each other very well. Ignore the time, that's not right. We've been battling with the elements and we've been battling with the data systems today, and we hope we've been able to make some sense of the race for you. Well, I think it's time for myself, Phil Minchell, and alongside me, Michelle Samick, to say goodbye. We're going off and having some lunch. The evening session, as you just see Maria Perez cross the line and take the gold medal in the women's 20-kilometre race walk. Well, there's many more gold medals to be decided tonight, and the evening session starts at 8 o'clock here in Berlin. That's 1800 GMT. But for now, we hope you enjoyed our coverage. We do apologise for the delay in commentary, but that was for circumstances outside of our control. Please do join us again this evening.
letzte Meter mit dabei, mit Teresa Zubeck. Und auch hier soll ich nochmal zeigen, was wir mit der Schnee über die tolle Stimmung haben können. Und die eben angesprochene Siegerehrung der Gierinnen und wir natürlich nicht das einzige Highlight, das sie hier und heute noch am Breitscheidplatz erwartet. Im Prinzip gibt es für die Abendplanung heute nur zwei Möglichkeiten. Entweder sie gehen kurzerhand noch ins Olympiastadion. Fans, das mit der Stimmung hier heute Morgen, heute Vormittag hat ja schon bestens geklappt. Und wir dürfen Sie gleich an dieser Stelle nochmal einladen, auf den Sonntagvormittag mit uns hier am Breitscheidplatz an andere European Mile oder in der Generali Arena zu verbringen, denn ein Straßengewend, das steht noch auf, aus nämlich die Marathon-Wettbewerbe. Auch da geht es wieder früh los, wenn denn nicht ein Feuerwehreinsatz dazwischen kommt. Das wollen wir mal hoffen. Also die herzliche Einladung morgen, 9.05 Uhr, Start Marathon der Frauen, 10 Uhr dann Start Marathon der Herren. Damit haben wir sie alle im Ziel, sehen hier nochmal den spanischen Sieger bei dieser spanischen Fiesta hier am Vormittag auf der European Mile. Zweimal Gold in dem Wettbewerb über 20 Kilometer für die Spanier und wie vorhin schon gesagt, diese Goldmedaille, die werden auch in Kürze hier the European Mile. Thank you.
Genau so sieht es aus. Wir haben ein paar korrigierte Zeiten aufgrund der Verschiebungen des Damenwettbewerbes. Wird es nun folgendermaßen sein. Wir werden in wenigen Augenblicken loslegen mit dem Bühnenprogramm in der Generali Arena. Sie sind herzlich eingeladen, dort hineinzukommen oder sich hinter der Tribüne vor den Rangordnern einzufinden. Wir werden dann die Siegerehrungen erleben, gehen 20 Kilometer Männer, gehen 20 Kilometer Frauen, Kilometer Hürden der Frauen, 800 Meter der Frauen, 1500 Meter der Männer und aus deutscher Sicht natürlich sehr erfolgreich. Siebenkampf der Frauen, das